Thank you, Ganesh. Hi, everyone, and greetings to all the listeners. I'm Annapurna, a PhD research scholar in National Institute of Technology, Rourkela, India. I'm doing my research under the guidance of Professor Dr. Susmita Das, who is one of the pioneer of wireless research in India. So as there is a crunch in time slot, so without further ado, let's get started. So I'm really interested to tell about the role of machine learning in 5G and beyond. And it's a really interesting topic, the role of machine learning in every researcher's mind. Every time a question pops in wireless researcher's mind that why machine learning and what's the significance of this one? So machine learning has already proved successful, has been successful in many of the areas like image processing, speech processing, and recommendation system. So it can solve complex engineering problems without explicit programming. So with the success of machine learning in this field, the use of ML in wireless communication has been advocated. But for the 5G cases, 5G requirement, there are a huge requirement for 5G. That is, requirements are like high data rate, low latency, high reliability, scalability, and large coverage due to billions of interconnection of IoT devices. So for those algorithmic design with high accuracy and which can perform under dynamic network conditions in wireless is also a challenging part. So there are many existing wireless scenarios or wireless communication algorithms like resource allocation algorithms. They are fast but heuristic in nature. So due to that, it's far optimal from the point of view of real-time deployment. So in those scenarios, machine learning can be a great game changer. The use of machine learning starting from medical diagnosis to the navigation in self-driving car, all those cases, it's everywhere. So machine learning allows wireless networks to learn and extract the knowledge by interacting with the data what we are providing. So the major difference between machine learning and the traditional cognitive algorithms are like automatic feature extraction. And those feature extractions can be implemented, and it can be the requirement for really handcrafted feature engineering. So the use of machine learning is also in case of like anomaly detection in the wireless communication, then prediction future scenarios and adapt fluctuations and all other cases. So depending on that, there are huge requirement for this machine learning in case of deployment. So coming to the broad view, that means the artificial intelligence is a broader sense which can mimic, where the computer can mimic the human intelligence. But in case of machine learning, it's the subset of AI, and it uses the statistical techniques to allow improve with the experience. And deep learning is a subset of machine learning in a deeper sense. It's the representation of our human brain, but not the exact, it's behave like a human brain where we are giving input and getting there are multi-layer neurons which does all the computation work. Now coming to the 5G service classes, there is a 5G requirement is huge, and it also comes with a challenge of a complex network. And along with that, there are three specific service classes defined by ITU, that is enhanced mobile broadband, then massive scale, that is a massive communication between the massive number of huge number of devices, and then the ultra reliable low latency communication. It can be applied to many of the service categories, starting from virtual reality, augmented reality, then comes to the monitoring, remote monitoring of the healthcare system, then comes the smart home system, smart cities, and vehicle-to-vehicle communication, and it's huge. The next generation industrial automation is also relying on some of the extreme use cases like massive machine-type communication and ultra-reliable low-latency communication. So due to this diversified requirement, in the diversify cases and these service classes to be satisfied, we as a researcher feel the requirement of these kind of machine learning models. So if according to the supervision level where the training is done, according to that it is divided into three types, that is supervised learning, unsupervised and reinforcement learning. So in case of supervised learning, the machine learning models itself gets the rule from the input data, because the input to the supervised learning models are label data, which from the label data it is getting the training samples, and using those training it can recognize the optimal solution for new inputs what we are giving. Then it is basically classified into two types, like classification and regression, all of us know that. And the use of this one, this supervised learning in various wireless communication has already been tested by a lot of researchers in this field, and it has been efficiently used in the mobility management, cache management, like for example in mobile edge computing in those cases. Then resource allocation, limited resource in wireless is also a biggest challenge, how we will do the resource allocation. So in those resource allocation case also, we can successfully, some of the implementation has already been done. Then support vector machine and deep neural networks are also useful in beam forming and localization, path loss prediction model. So these parameters use learning based approach to predict the performance in all the cases. Then in case of CSI detection, from unobservable CSI detection can be done from the observed pattern also. So in those case, supervised learning model of machine learning is really helpful. Now next comes the unsupervised learning. Unsupervised learning means, as we know that the input to this one is the unlabeled data. So in unlabeled data, it's try to find out the pattern, detect the pattern and relationship between the data which we are using. Now this, for example, in the clustering, it can be great in case of organizing the edge devices, and for example in the auto encoders also, which were the deep artificial neural networks. So in those cases they are used to parameterize the channel parameter and end to end communication deployment, and it's also been used for the dimensionality reduction and feature engineering. Similarly, for the fog node in heterogeneous communication, heterogeneous cellular network, unsupervised soft clustering can be very useful. Similarly, K-min clustering in those cases. So it's very useful in the base station decision-making process and the classification for the efficient relay selection and cooperative sensor spectrum sensing. So accordingly, the next case comes the reinforcement learning. Now, in reinforcement learning, the learning process is done according to the requirement of the, and it is done by the environment. That means the agent here, it continuously interact with the environment and gets the accordingly take the action and gets the reward. So the major aim of the reinforcement type of learning is to increase the long term reward. That means a discounted reward, and by this it takes a quick decision. There are various type of learning models are there, like Q learning, then multi-banded and actor critics. So they have already been used in some of the successful areas. Let for example, actor critic model. Here the action is taken by the actor depending on the current state, and the critic updates the action depending on the error value what it is getting, and accordingly it takes increases the rewards value.
Excuse
now
me.
It has been successfully implemented in case of it has been successfully implemented in some of the areas, like determining age of the information, and in case of deep learning systems. Now, with all these benefits also, like the two sides of the coin, when we are implementing ML system, that there are some inherent challenges are there. Before going to challenge, some more models like federated learning has recently been recently been introduced. So the use of federated learning in case of ready resource allocation, and it's having a great advantage there, but it also comes with the inherent challenge of heterogeneity among the data and the resources but in the federated learning. Similarly, with all the cases, we are also facing some of the challenges related to this deep learning, challenges related to the implementation of machine learning in 5G and beyond system. Now, in the including the challenge, the data availability. Now, the scarcity of real data is also a challenging system. The telecom industries, those who are getting real-time data, they are keeping those data as their valuable asset. So for us as a researchers, generating real-time data through computer simulation is always not a best practice, because when we are using it in the dynamic real-time environment, then it may not give that much of accuracy or interpretability. So again, another thing is a hyperparameter selection. Designing the model using computer selection, hyperparameter we are selecting before the training process, that can lead to the change of the parameters when it is deployed in the real-time scenario. That's also again big problem. Then uncertainty in generalization. The data for training, what we are taking, it should be generalized so that it can give the perfect accuracy as we are getting in our simulation setup. Then interpretability and accuracy trade-off is a biggest challenge again, because interpretable models are not so accurate. So having a trade-off between them is important.